And now for something completely different.
Here's what's coming up this hour on Today's Experience. It's Marvelous, Monumental, Most Fascinating, Massively Mind-Bending Monday, as we join our hearts and minds as one, drawing closer to the King of Kings and glorifying his name. First, we learn that Noah had three sons, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. And I am well aware of the humor accompanying the name of Ham. Who was the biggest entertainer in the Bible? Well, it was Ham. Get it? Okay. By the way, it is worthy to note that in regards to boating and the ark, God apparently owns the very first boat company, worth noting. Verse 11 teaches us that the earth had become utterly corrupt and rife with violence. Depravity was rampant. God decided to use Noah to initiate a reset or reboot to cleanse the darkness from the face of the earth. Now listen to this. Doesn't that sound somewhat like what heaven and the new earth will be like when we have a reboot using Jesus? Was God telling people ahead of time through that story what he was going to do? And finally, the Lord commanded Noah to construct an ark from resinous wood and seal it with tar, both inside and out. At this point, we can acknowledge the enormity of the task. Some estimates suggest that it took Noah nearly 100 years to complete this project. However, with God, all things are possible. No matter how daunting a task may seem, God will help us see it through to completion. No matter how daunting. In fact, Jesus is called the author and the finisher of our faith.
David Spoon's life has been an experience. While growing up in a Jewish family, he made a wrong turn towards drug abuse. Then David Spoon found Jesus Christ, and his life completely changed. The more he studied the gospel, the more he wanted to share his experiences with others. After 35 years of ministry, David discovered a new path of service. He joined KAAM, and this radio program began. You're about to hear the David Spoon Experience.
Welcome to the David Spoon Experience. Local, national, and heavenly talk. Here's what else we're looking at during the show. Lessons for surviving, living, and prevailing. Politics, entertainment, and current events. Personal revelations, spiritual observations, my life's insanities, and oy vey, so much more. Now remember, it's not professional radio, and let's just get that verified. It's just radio. Let's check with the dean of professional radio, our very own Jamming Jacob. Jamming Jacob, is the David Spoon Experience professional radio?
From the dean that what David calls me? No, it is not professional radio.
No, it is not professional radio. There he is. You heard it from Dean Jacob. Hey, we didn't use Dean Martin. We got Dean Jacob. Here it is. Bottom line, it's not professional radio. It's just radio. So relax, okay? Here's what we're asking you. What do you think? You can email us during the show. Pretty simple. david@hemusincrease.org. Let me make sure that's working. Every once in a while I do that, and it's just like it freezes. Nope, still working right now. Go, Chromebook, go. Anyhow, david@hemusincrease.org. You can also text 214-210-8483. That's 214-210-8483. Additionally, you can call us 972-445-0770. That's 972-445-0770. And when you call 972-445-0770, well, by golly, you'll end up talking to Jammin' Jacob. Talking to Jammin' Jacob is like knowing that your spiritual radio family has your back.
Aww.
Aww, that's so sweet.
Thank you, David. Happy Monday.
Happy Monday to you, my friend. I love another blitzing fast show. I just sometimes you get back here and you go, really? We've already done that segment there? Yeah, that's just how it goes. Anyway, great to have you. Hope you are doing well. So a little update on, so we did have somebody say they're having a little trouble on the station. Just want to know if we can reach out to our guy. And then also just a quick update on the book, the audiobook. We're looking at, what, 2-3 weeks or so into that ballpark of getting a little closer? Yep.
Yes, probably a couple weeks. I was thinking I could have it done by the end of the month, but last week I had extra stuff to do with Jennifer being gone all week.
Yep. So
I'll be working on it again this week, and, yeah, hopefully the next week or two getting it done.
Okay, cool. All right, so everybody keep aware of that. We'll let you know as that progresses. We'll be having basically an audio book. It's the Broken for His Glory book that we've gone through and recorded. I'm excited. I listened to a part of it and was like, hey, you know what's really funny about listening to your own audiobook? It sounds like you when you're listening to it. Okay, anyway. Let's move into what the reason is that you would reach out to us. You can reach out to us for a couple of different reasons. What are those reasons? Could be a praise report. It's up to you. It's up to you. It's up for you to respond as the Lord puts it on your heart. When should you do that? Whenever the Lord puts it on your heart. And that's the key. The key is just to follow the Lord the best you can. That's all anybody's trying to do here. We're all trying to do that. Everybody who says they walk perfectly with the Lord should just look at the life of Jesus and then be quiet. But we are all growing glory by glory, step by step. And that's the old, remember the old Three Stooges thing? Inch by inch, right? That's kind of how it goes. That's fine, because we're eternally set in the Lord, and now he's making us reflect how we are set, which is why we grow and reflect Jesus more and more. Okay, so in a nutshell, you can do a praise report. In another nutshell, you can do a prayer request. You got something you need prayer for? Let's pray about it. Is it always perfect? No. In fact, I think the great thing about prayer is that we bring it up to the Lord and that we don't tell him how to do it. We don't tell him, hey, we need. He knows those things. The reason that prayer even is in a part of this process is because prayer is us talking to God. And all of this, going back to the Garden of Eden with Adam and Eve, all of this is about fellowship. He wants you to pray so you spend time with him. That's why it's such an important part of things. He wants you to read so you hear what he has to say. Get that? That is what's going on there. Okay? All right. Additionally, you can possibly have something you just want to share, something that's on your heart. It's great. Maybe a scripture the Lord's given you. All that stuff is fantastic. Maybe even you'll have an answer to this trivia question. And we did this just earlier last week, so you guys should get this right away. Who said, I pray this, O God, that I may be avenged of the Philistines for my two eyes? Who said that? Judges chapter 16, verse 28. Judges chapter 16, verse 28. Who said, oh, that I could be avenged, Lord, and once avenged on the Philistines for my two eyes? If you think you know the answer, you can reach out to us, 972-445-0770. That's 972-445-0770. You can also text 214-210-8483. That's 214-210-8483. Or you can send an email, david@hemustincrease.org. That's david@hemustincrease.org. In the meantime, we're going to do our DNA. D stands for draw closer to the Lord.
Daily.
Every day. You know, I know it's like you're like, you know, Dave, you keep saying that. Well, there's two things. One thing I discovered I didn't even know, and this is me. I just want to be really honest with you. People think they know everything. It's like, no, nobody knows everything except for the Lord, right? Let's just leave it there. But I'm going through in this process where I'm talking to the Lord, and this is the thing. Just spending time with the Lord, and I'm praying, and I'm going over the Lord's Prayer. The Lord's Prayer is not you should recite this word for word. Jesus didn't say, recite these words. He said, pray in this manner, in this structure, is what it means. Our Father, who art thou in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive those who have debts against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Okay, people get that. I'm just sitting there going, yeah. So I'm saying that to the Lord, going through that structure. And the Lord shows me something I had never seen before in 45 years. After you're done addressing God Father who art thou in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. The rest of the prayer is plurality. In other words, give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive those who have debts against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. So it's all about God, then it's all about us, and then it's all about God. It's like, never saw that before. That's what I'm talking about. Just hang out with the Lord. He'll show you stuff like that. It's cool, right? Draw closer to the Lord daily. D. N. Never be ashamed of Jesus or his words. Luke 9:26. If you're ashamed of me and my words, I'll be ashamed of you when I come with the Father in glory. You don't want Jesus to be ashamed of you. Don't be ashamed of him. Don't be ashamed of what he had to say. Don't be ashamed of the gospel. It's an insult to God. Don't be ashamed. The world's going to look what the world just did the other day on the world stage, completely insulting the gospel and all Christians everywhere. You're going to care what those people think? Pfft, who cares what they think? It's absurd. Never be ashamed of Jesus or his words. And then A, always be ready.
To serve.
To serve. That is just the attitude of, what would you have me do today, Lord? Now, so you see the daily part. You see you never be ashamed. So you got this daily thing going. You got this never be ashamed going. And then you have this, I'm ready to do whatever you want. Here am I. Send me. And then you got to be honest. I think it's important for people to be honest. You got to be honest. You know, what if the Lord asked you to do something and you knew it was the Lord, would you do it no matter what? I mean, if it's God, right? We're not talking about something ridiculous, something that's a breach of command. But if the Lord wanted you to get involved in a task or reach out to somebody, do something, and you're like, no, would you yield and say, I'm ready. Use me. I'm your servant. I'm your clay. Mold me however you want. That's what it means to always be ready to serve. That's part of the meaning, I should say. D, draw closer to the Lord daily. N, never be ashamed of Jesus or his words. A, always be ready to serve. The trivia question before we get into the teach, simply this. Who prayed this prayer? Oh God, that I might avenge myself on the Philistines for what they've done to my two eyes. Who said that? Judges chapter 16, verse 28. If you think you know, 972-445-0770. You can also text 214-210-8483. As well, you can send an email, david@hemustincrease.org. We're going to pick it up in Genesis chapter 6, and we are at verse 9. This is the history of Noah and his family. Noah, we talked about this last week. Noah was a righteous man, the only blameless man living on earth at the time. He consistently followed God's will and enjoyed a close relationship with him. So we already know Noah's man, this dude, he is tight, he is in, he is doing great, fantastic. Verse 10, Noah had three sons, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. And then it picks it up in verse 11, and this is where it gets a little tougher. You go back to this and you just think how this would impact the Creator. Now, the earth had become corrupt in God's sight and was filled with violence. God observed all this corruption in the world and saw the violence and the depravity everywhere. So before we go into the exposit on that, we have somebody calling in and we will give them an opportunity to answer a trivia question. But just think about that when it talks about that the earth was filled with violence and depravity everywhere. There was no good. That goes back to Romans 3. There is none righteous, no, not one. None seek after God. Well, that applies right there, doesn't it? Wow. Different times in history, it has been like that in different ways. And as the Creator looking at your creation, thinking, why did you do this? Right? All right, somebody's ready to answer a trivia question. Let's send them on through. Knock, knock. This is David. Who am I talking to?
Hi, David. It's Deborah.
Hi, Deborah. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. I hope you're doing well.
I am doing very, very well. I like this new phone thing that you're working on, or this phone. It just sounds really good for you. Your voice sounds really good.
Oh, good, good.
I'm just letting you know. Okay. I know most people don't respond like that, but that's how I look at things. Okay, let's get this set up, and then you can knock this out of the park. Who was the guy that said, "I pray, Lord, this one time you let me avenge the Philistines for what they did to my two eyes"? Who said that?
I'm just guessing. Is it Samson?
That is correct, Amundo! Samson said that, and he was just asking the Lord, you know what, for all the stuff they just did to me, Lord, I'll go down with them. That's all good, but, you know, let's just take them all down, take them all out. And the Lord heard the prayer and answered it, and so it was.
The answer was Samson.
And one of the most unique judges in all of Scripture. You're sitting there thinking, that guy would never have gotten through 1st or 2nd Timothy or Titus on anything. But yet, God still used him, right? I mean, that's the truth
right.
of the matter.
Hey, do you have a prayer request?
Yes, absolutely.
I was wondering if you could please pray for Susie to have her pain removed, and also the person that she's going to see will actually help her this time.
Okay. So is it like a new doctor, a new person,
yes.
a new expert?
Yes,
okay.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Let's do it. Let's do exactly that. Let's pray that exact way. Okay? Let's
thank
do it. Father, we come before you right now. First, we thank you for Deborah. She's a blessing, and we'd love to hear from her and just pray you would bless her because she's one of our wonderful people. And, Lord, we lift up Susie, who's her friend. Deborah's not even praying for herself, praying for a friend. And, Lord, Susie's been in a lot of pain. She's having pain in different parts of her body, like her feet and everywhere else, and she's just really struggling, and she needs help. Now, we ask you, Lord God, that you would bring healing power into her life. And we ask you that you would touch her and that you would reduce the frustration, the pain, and how much it debilitates her. And she's also going somewhere new, Lord, and we're asking you to give that person wisdom, insight, knowledge, a capacity to be a helper, that there can be some benefit from the engagement. Help Susie in her pain and help the person she's going to have the wisdom to help her reach that right place. And let grace help them both. We just ask you this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen and amen.
Thank you so much, David. I appreciate that.
You got it. And God bless you.
God bless. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. All right. Another great call from Deborah, world's greatest guesser on trivia, by the way. She's so good. See, no matter what happens at this point after 5 years, she'll always have that title because it's like every time she answers a trivia question, she goes, is it, you know. That's good.
She's like, she has like a 99% correction.
Mostly, I'm pretty confident
but
here.
Every single
I'm
one, she's
confident.
Like, is it this?
Yeah, that's great. All right, so let's look at this, and then I don't want to spend too much time because we want to go to the next thing. Here it is in a nutshell. God has the world before him. It's his creation. It's just total depravity. I don't think we understand. I think some people look at political parties and think their entire parties are political depravity. I think this is a little more intense. I'm just going to go out on a limb. This is to the point where God is like, I'm going to wipe everything out. That is how bad. All they're doing, everything they're doing, not only is it depraved, okay, but it's filled with violence. Nothing but violence. I'm not talking about occasional violence. I'm not talking about the news reports of violence. This is continual. The Lord said, nope, this ain't going to work. And this is something that people should be aware of. And I like what the one person said. Hey, you want to know something? Do not be deceived, the Bible says. God is not mocked. What a man sows, that shall he also reap. And when the world does things and then supports it that are mocking of God, the judgment will be what is deserved and just. And the way things are heading, it almost feels like we're getting back to those days of Noah, which is ironic since Jesus mentioned towards the end how that would be a return in that direction. The last time the Lord said, that's enough, but he wiped them out. Next time it'll be for the return of Jesus Christ. And those that love Jesus will be like, see you later, alligator, in a while, crocodile. Yeah, you know what? I look forward to the Lord's return. You should too. All right, we'll take a short break and then come back. You're listening to the David Spoon Experience right here on KAAM 770, the Truth Station here in Texas. Short break. We'll be back. Don't go anywhere.
Since the dawn of the internet, people have been looking for a website they can be proud of without costing an arm or a leg. People want a quality website to promote their ministry, business, hobby, or passion. Introducing Cowpunch Sites. Cowpunch Sites can help you create and maintain a quality website. From design to security, Cowpunch does it all. Cowpunch is a family-owned and operated business, taking a fresh approach to business. Lots of clients at lower prices. Make mom happy.
The most significant benefit of working with Cowpunch Sites is that you work with real people, not cheesy templates. No outsourcing. It's $57 a month, and there's no setup fee and no cancellation fees. When you go to cowpunchsites.com/dad. That's cowpunchsites.com/dad. That's me. Oh, did I mention that it's $57 a month? Cowpunch Sites, $57 a month, and that's no bull.
Dave, this is a nice radio station.
Oops, sorry. That's Cowpunch Sites, $57 a month, and that's no baloney. There, that's better. Cowpunchsites.com/dad.
What is the David Spoon Experience?
What the issue is this guy hears the gospel from Philip, and in that presentation of the gospel is baptism. That is not negotiable in the sense that there's no way you can remove that. And he responds by saying, I want to be part of this family. I want to be connected to this. I hear the good news. I want the grace and the mercy. I want to do whatever it takes to show my response, not just to you, Philip, but to the entire world. I'm a Christian. And that's what baptism does. And while I think it's dangerous to say, if you're not, you can never get in, because I don't believe that's correct, I also think it's dangerous to say nobody needs to do it. That's incorrect, too. Your baptism is an open proclamation of an inward work. Don't you ever forget, the Lord requires that. If you've never been baptized, get baptized. Don't, oh, we've got to do it right this way. Arrange to get baptized. That's it. If you've never done it, you should do it because it's a declaration of your faith. That's the response to the gospel. You're saying by identifying going down and up in baptism, the end of you, the beginning of him in you. Okay. That just seems like a, doesn't even seem like that's complex. I think everybody should just go, yeah, okay, got it. Welcome back to the David Spoon Experience. Thank you for joining us here at KAAM 770, the Truth Station here in Texas. That's KAAM 770, the Truth Station here in Texas. We're getting ready for our next trivia question. I hope you guys are ready for this one. Whom is this referring to? This man prayed for wisdom and knowledge, and God replied, wisdom and knowledge will be given you, and I will also give you wealth, riches, and honor, such as no king who is before you have ever had, and none will have afterward. Who is that? If you think you know, 972-445-0770. That's 972-445-0770. You can also text 214-210-8483. And by the way, the best reference for this is 2 Chronicles chapter 1, verse 9 through 12. So let me say that again. 2 Chronicles. Hey, sometimes it takes me a second to get the reference out. 2 Chronicles chapter 1, verse 9 through 12. Who prayed for wisdom? And God said, wisdom, I'm going to give you more than that. Wealth, riches, honor, such as nobody has had before you, nor will have after you. Who said that? If you think you know, like I said, 972-445-0770. You can also text 214-210-8483. Additionally, you can send an email, david@hemustincrease.org. So I am going to warn you ahead of time that I am going to do at least two jokes. So my real question is for Jam and Jacob to help me coordinate. Should we do the trivia question first and then the two jokes? Or do you want to do it the other way around?
Let's do the trivia question first.
Let's do the trivia question first. Okay, here we go. We have somebody on the line, so let's send them on through. Knock, knock. This is David. Who am I talking to?
Oh, this is your little brother.
Hello, little brother, who was the answer to the last trivia question. How you doing?
I'm okay.
Yeah? Up and down, right?
Yes. Pray for me. Today I'm just having a little bit fear.
Okay. All right. Not a problem. Let's do this first. Let's do the trivia question, and then we'll just kind of examine the fear and see where that goes. All right. Who prayed? And I know you're going to get this, but you got to let me go through it. The man who prayed for wisdom and knowledge, and God said, "Wisdom and knowledge, I'm going to give you wealth, riches, honor that no king has had before you, nor will ever have after you." 2 Chronicles 1:9-12. Who was that?
Oh, that was the son of Bathsheba and David, and his name was Solomon.
That is correct, Amanusa! You are right, sir. That is right, right, right. And even though that whole situation was super, super bad, afterwards, God gave enormous grace to that situation, and then good did eventually come out of that. So that just shows you all things do work together for good to them that love God, to them that are called according to his purpose. So, my brother, what is the fear that's going on? Is it fear for family, for yourself, for health, for people, for the country? What's the fear?
Right now for me.
Okay, fair
enough. I don't know, on other day, like even this morning, I was just feeling a little pain on my left arm and upper chest. So I don't know, maybe it's a muscle spasm or something. So that just gives me fear. So
okay.
I'm praying, Lord, shall I call doctor and go there, or it's just a muscle spasm?
Got it. So you got things that are happening, and then they're moving you to kind of fearful conclusions without knowing the conclusion.
That's correct.
Okay, let's pray about it right now. Okay, you ready?
Sure.
Let's do it. Father, we come before you right now, and of course we pray for our brother Samson. Now, Lord, we thank you for him. He's a blessing and needs to know that there's a mission, there's a purpose, and he will not exit 1 second before the mission is completed. Even if he doesn't know what the full mission is yet, that's irrelevant. But he is open to you leading and guiding and directing him. But he also deals, Lord God, with a lot of death and a lot of people that are hurting. And so that tends to create bigger chasms in those realms. And so as a brother, as a friend, as a co-laborer, I ask you, Lord, to fill in some of those empty gaps, because he has to deal with that kind of ministry. Fill in those gaps for him, not with something that leads to fear, but something that leads to peace and courage. Not one moment before the time that you've appointed, not one moment before his reservation that you have, according to Hebrews 9:27. Not one moment before. Not one moment before. And Lord, let him be at rest. The enemy's going to try and use that against him. And when he sees that it's tormenting, give him the discernment, because that's not how you do it, Lord. You don't use that form of fear to torment. So let him discern that and rebuke the enemy at those times. And let him have great confidence in your faithfulness. Let him have rest and peace. And let him fulfill the ministry you've put before him. We lift him up to you and ask you to break the power of the enemy that's tormenting. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Amen. Amen. Hey, I'm going to quickly share a testimony, and I want to thank every body, those who prayed for me and our David Spoon Experience family. The last Saturday when I did a funeral, even though it was hard, but I felt, I guess that was one of those funerals that afterward I felt so good, and I feel like that Lord touched some people's life. They didn't know God, or they knew God and they were drifted, and I just had a supernatural feeling that they are coming back to the Lord.
Amen.
So I just wanted to say thank you, everybody, even though while I was going there and preparing myself and during just start of the funeral, I wasn't feeling so good. And I said, Lord, help me that I will be fully present to do this funeral for your glory. And it turned out to be a joy.
Amen. That's great testimony, brother, and we appreciate that. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Praise His
name. Yeah, and I want to thank all our audience. Thank you for praying for me.
Yeah, you're our brother, and we love you, bro.
And I love you, too.
Okay, God bless.
God bless. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. All right. So just in lieu of time, we'll exit here, and then I'll come back. And yes, I'm telling those jokes, so don't think you're getting away with it. People trying to escape the jokes. Are you kidding? All right, you're listening to the David Spoon Experience right here on KAAM 770, the Truth Station here in Texas. Short break. We'll be back. Don't go anywhere.
The Christian faith is being attacked. 50 years ago, people would disagree with Christianity, but with a sense of respect. Those days are over. The rage, the flesh, the enemy, and the atmosphere of sin is growing and growing. Jesus said in Matthew 24, the love of many will grow cold. And if it's not the end now, it's certainly a lot closer than it was yesterday. You may be from a Baptist background. David Spoon has that. You may have a Pentecostal background. He has that too. You may have a non-denominational background. Yep, he's got that as well. You may be from the Church of Christ, Presbyterian, Methodist, Church of God, or some other denomination. But if you're looking for a show that's Bible-based, Spirit-led, and a bit nutty, give David a listen for a while. If you like it, great. If not, no worries. The David Spoon Experience.
What is the David Spoon Experience?
Let me tell you what I'm torn between the two. I'm twixt between the torn two. You want to know why? I've got the biggest breaking story ever.
No, you need to do that first. Yeah, I just can't wait.
More than my whole thing about the four-way stop sign?
Yep.
You want me to do the number one story?
That's
Ladies
right.
and gentlemen, you better get ready. Here's my advice. I don't give this advice very often, and I don't give it uncheckfully. What's uncheckfully? I don't know. Here's the biggest story you have ever heard on the David Spoon Experience. If you have children who are listening, if you are not in a car, it's time to cover their ears or send them into another room. That's how chilling this is. Ladies and gentlemen, I have it off the press literally within the last 2.5 hours. Actually, it's less than 2.5 hours ago. Here it is, ladies and gentlemen. I have it right in my hands. Get ready. Do not get nauseous when you hear this. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a fact that as of today, the Navy, the United States Navy, officially has made its proclamation. Ready? Are you ready? Are you listening? This is the most important thing ever. You ready? That Captain Crunch is a fraud. Ladies and gentlemen, the United States Navy has declared that Captain Crunch...
I do not buy it.
No, listen to this. Here's why. Let me tell you why. Captain Crunch has 3 stripes on his cuffs, and that signifies a commander and not a captain. So the United States Navy has made it absolutely known today, Captain Crunch, nay... He nay a captain. Nay. Now, it is true.
Are we gonna rename the cereal?
No.
Commander Crunch?
Yes, Commander Crunch. That's the new. That's why I told you, don't let your kids hear this. It is possible that that uniform could represent either German or Portuguese Navy. They are not sure because all of those uniforms were lost with their great navies. Welcome back to the David Spoon Experience. Thank you for joining us here at KAAM 770, the Truth Station here in Texas. That's KAAM 770, the Truth Station here in Texas. Getting ready for our next trivia question. Then I'm going to send people to the website. Then I'm going to tell my jokes. And then we're going to go back into the teaching. And that's how it's going to go. Here's your next trivia question. This man prayed. And then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt sacrifice and the wood and the stones and the dust and licked up the water that was in the trench. Who was he? 1 Kings chapter 18, verses 36 through 38. Who was he? That is the question. Wow, that is serious, serious. If you think you know, 972-445-0770. That's 972-445-0770. You can also text 214-210-8483. That's 214-210-8483. Or send an email, david@hemustincrease.org. I need to send you up to the website, and I can tell you all the cool stuff that's on there. Please don't forget that the books are on there, and if you want one of the books, you can have them for free, no cost. We will pay for them and send them to you. They're not going to come like UPS per se, or they're not coming FedEx, but they'll get to you. And the bottom line is on the website's a place to give, and giving is very helpful to us. Because as we've told you before, if there's no giving, this is what you hear. Which doesn't seem like very much. Anyway, check it out on the website, hemustincrease.org.
Prayer request?
hemustincrease.org.
Praise report?
hemustincrease.org.
Looking to give to this ministry?
hemustincrease.org.
Confused by what's happening right now?
hemustincrease.org.
hemustincrease.org.
You're still here? It's over. Go home.
Okay, we do have somebody ready to answer a trivia question, so let's send them on through. Knock, knock, this is David. Who am I talking to?
Hi, David, this is Fred.
Hello, Fred, how are you?
I'm doing fine, sir.
All right, now, I'm going to set it up for you. Give you a chance to hit it out of the park. Here we go. This man prayed, and then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt sacrifice and the wood and the stones and the dust and licked up the water that was in the trench. Who was he? 1 Kings 18, 36 through 38. Who was he?
That would be Elijah.
Elijah is correct!
And you know what? He made a mockery out of the prophets of Baal. One of the things he suggested is that maybe your God has went to the restroom, and I thought that was hilarious.
That is one of the great unknown lines. when a lot of the translations, it goes, maybe he's busy. That's not what it said. That is so lame. Interpreters get to be afraid sometimes to say things, kind of like when Jesus said, I'm going to spit you out of my mouth. That was upchuck. I mean, it's just like, come on, just call it what it is. It's not even that big a deal. It's like, maybe he's like in the John, man. I mean, what? I mean, that's what he said. And it's like, okay.
That's what he said. Yes, like, absolutely. I'm going to hang up and I'm going to let you finish the show. I'm listening.
All right, my brother. God bless you. Excellent job. Great answer.
All right.
Bye-bye. All right. Before we get to the teaching, I am going to do these couple jokes because they're funny and I don't care. Is that allowed? Are you allowed to do stuff like that? I don't care. All right, here we go. Ready? Three jokes. Well, they're very short. Ready? All right. First one's a thought joke. The second one is just kind of goofy. And the third one is genius. Ready? Okay. First one. Dad to his son, Keith. What happened to your eye, Keith? I was staring at a ball from far off. And I was wondering, why is it getting bigger and bigger? And then it hit me. This one, not as funny, although the third one's the funniest. I had lunch with a chess champion the other day. It took him 20 minutes to pass the salt. Okay, that got buzzed. This will not get buzzed, though. Hey, you, yelled the ranger to a child. Can't you read that sign? No fishing in the river. Oh, I'm not fishing, said the young man. I'm teaching my worm how to swim. That's a good one, too, right? Teaching my worm how to swim. Okay. That's right. Those are funny. Just acknowledge. All right, let's go back to Noah. We don't talk about this a lot because, to me, it's amazing. There's some questions on some of the years involved here, but this is that's not the point. People get so caught up in these things. Here's what it says. This is verse 11. I said, we mentioned this before, by the way. The earth has become corrupt in God's sight, was filled with violence. God observed all the corruption in the world. He saw the violence and depravity everywhere. God said to Noah, I've decided to destroy all living creatures on the earth because the earth is filled with violence because of them. Yes, I will wipe them all from the face of the earth. Here it is. Here's where we get into it. Verse 14. Ready? Make an ark. Now, in the next says it's either gopher wood or resinous wood. Or make an ark from resinous wood and seal it with tar inside and out. Then construct decks and make stalls throughout the interior. Make it 450 feet long, 75 feet wide, and 45 feet high. Can we say that again, please? 450 feet long. For you guys to understand, a 100-yard football field is 300 feet. This is a football field and a half. That's the length. 75 feet high, or 75 feet wide. That's pretty wide. Which I think a football field's 50. I think it's 50 feet wide. I can't even remember now. But it's like one and a half of those. And then 45 feet high. Construct an opening all the way around the boat, 18 inches below the roof. Then put three decks inside the boat, bottom, middle, and upper, and put a door in the side. Let's just stop right there. I don't care about anything else. I want you to hear this one thing. God told Noah to build a boat. To build an ark. Let's just get this. You know the distance of a football field. So take one and a half of those and just think, this is a big boat. This is not two cops in a rowboat. This is a big boat, right? I just got to say this because there's no way you can think of this any other way. Now, people are living longer back then. That's not the issue. That's not even what's a question. But this came about when Noah was about 500. So he's, you know, halfway through life. So if we're living till we're 80, you kind of like think of it as when you're 40, right? Kind of thing. That's all I'm trying to help you. Or if they live till 90, 45, or 100, then think about it, 50. And now that he's older, he's got this task. And how big is this task? He's got to build a boat that's 450 feet long and 75 feet wide. All I want you to get out of this little thing, is there are times where God will ask you and I to do a task that is absolutely enormous. It is not a task that can be done instantly. It's not a task that can be done with a snap of a finger. You can't just say, oh, I'm just going to get this one. This is not one of the, this is not the to-do list type of task. This is a life-impacting, life-changing task. The Lord has asked some of you, I'm just going to say it, I want you to get involved in ministry. Ministry? I'm too old to get in ministry. I'm too this to get in ministry. That's all excuses. Some of you, the Lord's asked you to do something that's a part of your life. Maybe it's adding education. Maybe it's adding a different career. Any of those things. Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if the task seems just huge, impossible. Who can possibly foresee of doing this, building a boat this long? How could you even think of how we could pull this off? How daunting this task is. It's too big for me, God. You know, kind of like, hey, go lead the children of Israel, the entire nation, out of Egypt and into the promised land. Are you kidding? Do you know how much work that is? If the Lord wants you to do a work, it doesn't matter if it's overly daunting or not. And it doesn't quite matter, to be honest, if you're the only person involved or if you're the one that will complete it or anything else. If the Lord wants you to do something, here's the key. Do it. Dave, it can't be God. It's impossible to do. God often asks us to do things that are simplistic, that are mediocre, and that are just crazy wild. I mean, you don't think it was crazy wild when Peter goes, ah, if it's really you, let me come out of the boat. Okay, come on. I'm trying to give you this sense that God will have you do things that are bigger than you. Because it's true. They're things for the kingdom. And just because it's huge doesn't mean it's not doable. But Dave, I don't think I'll live long enough to accomplish it. So God didn't say, do this, but I'll make sure you live long enough unless he told you that. If he says do it, just do it. Maybe it gets passed down from generation to a generation. Maybe it gets handed over to other people. I don't know. But maybe God just wants you to do it so you can be obedient before him. Maybe the Lord's asked you to do something in ministry in his relationship. I want you to spend a half hour with me every day. I'm not saying he's saying that to you. I'm trying to tell you. Maybe he just asked something that you're just thinking, I don't know how it can be done. I don't figure out how I can fit it in my list. Well, congratulations and welcome to Christianity. God doesn't typically just wait to see what you think is okay, and certainly doesn't do that with me. I thought I was done with ministry at 50. Apparently, I didn't even start ministry till 50. That's how much I know. Just because it's daunting, and in fact, because it's daunting, might make it even more biblically oriented or more God-like or more spirit-led. Don't be afraid if it's a big task. Do what the Lord has before you. The timing, the completions, and everything else are all a part of the partnership. God is looking to partner with you. Partner with him. He loves that. That's what eternity is going to be about. Okay, we'll take a short break and then come back. You're listening to the David Spoon Experience right here on KAAM 770, the Truth Station here in Texas. Short break. We'll be back. Don't go anywhere.
The David Spoon Experience.
I'm not going to do an overriding teaching that will make the Baptists or the Church of Christ proud, so neither one of you groups can be all excited about this because that's not the purpose of this. Here's where we're picking it up. As verse 34 ends, the eunuch asks Philip, what was Isaiah talking about, himself or someone else? Verse 35 from Acts chapter 8 says, Philip began with the same scripture and then began to tell him about the good news about Jesus. As they rode along, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, look, there is some water. Why can't I be baptized? So let's just stop right there. When Philip was explaining the gospel to the eunuch, he had to include the understandings or the teachings of baptism, or the eunuch never would have said, why can't I be baptized? He never would have said it, never would have come up, unless Philip had brought that information to light. In multiple translations, it then says, you can, Philip answered, if you believe with all your heart. And the eunuch replied, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. This is often known as believer's baptism. Some texts will show this in the footnote. I disagree that it should be reduced to the footnote. I think it's a part of the text. I would not fellowship with you over that. I just think it is a part of the text because he asks a very pointed question. And in this exchange, Philip is giving a very pointed answer. So he's like, well, there's some water. I want to be baptized. I want to respond to the gospel. I want to say yes. And Philip responds by saying, you can. You can get baptized. As long as you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, you can be baptized. Now, why that's important is because this is the difference between many different groups about who can be baptized. Some people think, well, a child can be baptized. Yeah, but a child can't believe in Jesus, so then how can a child be baptized? That's the argument, okay? Those are not fellowship issues. Those are disagreements. You know, I spent 10 minutes talking about understanding who's got the Spirit of God and who doesn't have the Spirit of God. When you have a difference of application of Scripture, that person's not an evil person. They're not some kind of demonic whatever. They see something different than you. Okay. They're genuinely in a relationship with Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus Christ is what redeems us. They are acknowledging their heavenly Father, praying, our Father who art thou in heaven. They drink of the same Holy Spirit. They come to a different conclusion. Yeah. What else is new? Does everybody think McDonald's is the best fast food? Are you kidding? There's only a few people.
Sometimes
Oh, Welcome back to the David Spoon Experience. Thank you for joining us here at KAAM 770, the truth station here in Texas. That's KAAM 770, the truth station here in Texas. Here's your last trivia question. It might be considered a little harder, but I think you guys can get this. Okay, this is out of Judges, chapter 6, 22 through 25. So you know it's a judge, right? Because it's out of Judges, right? Okay. This man saw an angel of the Lord and thought he was going to die. That night the Lord told him to throw down his father's altars of Baal and could cut down his father's grove. Which younger judge was this? This man saw an angel of the Lord and thought he was going to die. That night, the Lord told him to throw down his father's altar of Baal and cut down his father's groves. Judges chapter 6, verses 22 through 25. Here's your only other hint. Because of him, many of us offer fleeces to the Lord. Because of him, many of us offer fleeces to the Lord. Get that? Okay. This man saw an angel of the Lord and thought he was going to die. That night the Lord told him, throw down his father's altar of Baal and cut down his father's grove. Judges chapter 6, verse 22 through 25. Also because of this guy, many of us offer fleeces to the Lord. See if you can pick up on that. If you think you know the answer, 972-445-0770. You can also text 214-210-8483. Additionally, you can send an email, david@hemustincrease.org. I am going to do a little bit of history because there's a couple things on here that I really like. So, history.
Let's go live big in the past. Let's go live big in the past.
All right, now it is true that whenever there's a food item or two, I am a little more prone to do history. That is a fact of life. And here is the first one. Today is National Lasagna Day. Hello.
Today's a good day.
Today is a good day. I love lasagna. I'm not sure why anybody doesn't. I like lasagna. Meat, you know, I just love it. Okay. Also, so not to be outdone by that, and this is true for me because I'm one of those weird people that like this maybe more than I'm supposed to, and I confess it, so I'm not denying it or anything. It's not only is it National Lasagna Day, but for those that do not know, today is also National Chicken Wings Day, and chicken wings are one of my favorite snackaroonies. In fact, one of my favorite snacks, I'll just tell you that you guys don't know this yet, is I love the peanut Thai flavored chicken wings. I know not everybody can eat that, but I happen to love that a great deal. Thank you very much. Also on this day, 1958, NASA was created. The National Aeronautics and Space Administration, NASA, was created. Also, 1954. Wow. The Fellowship of the Ring, the first part of the Lord of the Rings trilogy, was published. There you go. A lot of stuff. All right, we do have somebody who is ready, I think, to... Are they ready to answer a trivia question? No, they're not ready to answer because they might have been just calling to get pizza. So we'll just talk about that later. Your trivia question, if I can find my trivia sheet, is... Wait, here it is. This man saw an angel of the Lord and thought he was going to die. That night the Lord told him to throw down his father's altar of Baal and cut down his father's grove. Also, this judge was very connected to the concept of a fleece before the Lord. That should make that pretty easy. You can call 972-445-0770, but you only got 3 minutes. You can text 214-210-8483 or send an email, david@hemustincrease.org. With this 3 minutes, I want to make sure to drive home the major point of what we're talking about with Noah, and it's simply this. Noah was given an absolutely daunting task. We can get that. But what we need to understand is in the Old Testament and the New Testament, a very similar phrase comes up, With Abraham, the phrase, is anything too hard for the Lord? And in the New Testament, from Gabriel and from Jesus himself, is anything too hard for the Lord? Some of us are operating in a high limitation because we're not recognizing that faith opens doors that the intellectual mind cannot grasp. You might not like it, and people don't, but it is an absolute empirical fact that the lower the education, the higher the miraculous rate is for things that cannot be explained. And that is because some of us intellect God to no effect. Well, I've got to be able to place this here. It's got to make sense here. It's got to work here. It's got to be logical here. Right. So you do know in the universe that some planets spin one way and some planets spin another, right? I'm just asking, right? I mean, I just think that's rather funny. And you do understand that when the world was created, the biblical account is that God created the trees and everything else, and then the sun was the day after some of those trees and plants. And you just think about that. That's impossible. Right. So it's all part of the witness. God does things that just make no sense because God is a God of miracles. You know what he's looking for? He's looking for people that believe he's a God of miracles. And it only takes a moment for a miracle. So do we step up and believe? This task is impossible. I can never do it. With God, all things are possible. All right, the man who saw the angel and thought he was going to die, and that night the Lord told him to throw down his father's altar of Baal and cut down his father's grove, and we get a lot of fleecing from this guy. That judge was Gideon, who put out a fleece before the Lord on the rain. Actually, he put out two fleeces before the Lord, and that's where we say, Lord, just do this, and I'll do this. Yeah, that's where it comes from, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Okay, folks, you've been listening to the David Spoon Experience right here on KAAM 770, the Truth Station here in Texas, 22.5-hour break. Then we'll come back. More Insanity with Spoonanity. Talk to you then.
Just as I am, he reached down and saved me. Purchased my freedom at the cost of his son.
Views and opinions expressed in the preceding program are those of its participants and do not necessarily reflect those of KAAM, DJRD Broadcasting, or its sponsors.